Life is like a book, and a man's existence is like flipping through the chapters of the book. The political chapter of Honorable Olatoye Temitope Sugar's life is like a river from where everyone drinks to satisfaction. The general election that took place in 2015 in the Federal Republic of Nigeria certainly ended the tenure of office of the previous administration. This change of government paved the way for the election of Honorable Olatoye Sugar into the Federal House of Representatives to represent the people of Lagelu Akinyele Federal Constituency, which have over 300,000 people. It is stated clearly in the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria that the House of Representatives has the power to make laws for the peace, order, and good governance of the Federation. The House of Representatives also has broad oversight functions and is therefore empowered to establish committees to scrutinize bills and the conduct of government institutions and officials. Honorable Olatoye Sugar has been around these for 2 years now, dutifully making laws and serving as the chairman, House Committee on Urban Development and Regional Planning for the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
Who's an honorable? An honorable is a representative, a worker, who represents the interests of the majority. In my constituency, like God's ways, I have over 300,000 people there, and everybody cannot be put in. But by his grace, I was elected to his office to represent my people. And there are functions. I'll start from there. The first function is to make law. As well as we're making law, there are some laws that have been already existing, but that need to be repealed. So aside this, we have what we call oversight function. So which we usually do from the office to look after the agencies, the parastata, the ministry of what they have taken from the center, maybe from the federal government. So, apart from this, we have to represent interests, whatever our followers, our people in our constituency, what they need. We have to tell the executive that this is what they need, this is what they need as a representative. And the executive, we take the one that they know that they can do. And at the same time, we had as a watchdog on the SS of executive. The power vested on the executives are too much than other arms of government. That is why our forefathers, the beginners of what we are going to do, and as been practicing in the Western world, that three tiers of government, the executive, the judiciary, and something, the legislature.
His current stint in the National Assembly will not be his first assignment politically, as his political journey started with a political appointment as a supervisory councillor in Odeda local government in Ogun State. He was thereafter chosen as a special advisor to the former Ogun State Governor, Otumba Gbenga Daniel, having been the PDP youth leader in Ogun Central Senatorial District for years. While serving in Ogun State, his love and passion for his home state, Oyo, motivated him into sponsoring political developments in Oyo State before his full adventure as a chairmanship aspirant in Lagelu local government area of Oyo State in 2007 under the umbrella of People's Democratic Party, PDP. He later became the PDP National Delegate of Oyo State in the year 2008. Having been fenced out of his political home, the PDP, where he labored tirelessly with his human and material resources to garner support from his ward to the national level, Honorable Sugar did not rest on his oars, but went ahead to contest on the platform of the then newly formed Accord Party. Backed by the love and support of the masses and downtrodden, he was elected into the Oyo State House of Assembly in 2011, where he performed creditably well to the commendation of the Oyo State Governor, the Peguru and Kushelari One of Oyo State himself. His Excellency, Governor Abiola Isiaq Ajimobi, who was impressed by the outstanding performance of Honorable Sugar at improving the lives of people in his constituency and beyond through his several people-oriented programs and empowerment. Honorable Sugar's good works, exemplary achievements, and increasing political profile in the main politics of Oyo State endeared him to many within and outside the state, which earned him an invitation to join the then Action Congress of Nigeria, ACN. He also actively participated in the formation of the current ruling party, the All Progressives Congress, APC, in Oyo State. Honorable Dr. Olatoye Temitope Sugar, in his 2 years as a lawmaker representing Lagelu Akinyele Federal Constituency of Oyo State in the House of Representatives, Abuja, has taken certain giant legislative strides in sponsoring people and institutional-oriented bills, which are Motion on Negligence of Duty, Exploitation of Masses by Nigeria Customs Service.
Dr. Olatoye Temitope Sugar, representing good people of Lagelu Akinyele Federal Constituency, Ibadan, Oyo State. I rise to support the motion, ably with my honorable colleagues. Earlier, before these times, there was a motion that I moved on the floor of the line on the issue of custom, the negligence of Nigerian custom officers, like covering the excess of the Nigerian customs. These customs officers that we are having in Nigeria, they have been behaving beyond the act that propounded them. We are act in the 1918 that propounded them, the Sema Law of 1977. All these laws that propounded the customs, they are behaving and reacting outside the law. There is no law that has given them the room or heart that they should be going to individual houses, going to the car lots, going to the market, using brain to take the market. They used money to borrow most of this business. Look at the what we are experiencing in Nigeria. At this hour, the custom, they will leave the border. We have sea border, we have land border. They will leave there where the laws has them to stay and be getting to the market by taking the cloth. They said this cloth is for China. This cloth that you have is not Nigerian made. They take it away without getting anything. They go to market where they are selling tires. They take their tires away, taking different things away for their own use, and they use brain to steal the market of the Nigerian movie that we are representing. So this motion comes at the right time, and the good motion that all of us must support in order to fight these negligence and copying the essence of the Nigerian custom. They have to stay at the border. That is what the law says. There's no law that gives them the authority to be stopping the vehicle all across the way. When you're thinking of how you succeed or to move ahead from on this recession and the calamity that we are facing in Nigeria, they will just stop them, taking their vehicle to unknown destination, go to the market, the insurance market, averting their properties without getting any other power, using the gun to kill the Nigerians unknowingly. So, and immediately you will not see them, but they are, because they put on the uniform of the Nigerian custom and they are unknown soldier. So I stand to support this motion that the honorable colleagues, we should stand together and fight this battle. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Those in favor of the motion say aye. Those against it say nay. Ayes have it.
And joining us now to shed more light on this issue is House of Representatives member of the All Progressives Congress representing Oyo State, Mr. Temitope Olatoye. Welcome to Newstrack.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. In passing, in considering this motion, you're obviously looking at duplication of duties on the part of the Customs Service in mounting roadblocks where the goods have been allegedly illegally smuggled across the border already.
Of course, yes.
Why is this important for it to be addressed now?
Well, that's what we call separations of power in the law in Nigeria. There's no need of duplication. Police has their duty, one Nigerian army has their own duty. The Nigerian Customs Service, they have their own duty. And out of their own duty is to defend the interests of Nigeria at the border point and to prevent the smuggling. And at the same time, they have to generate income for Nigeria, for the federal government. But instead of this, they will leave their homework. So far, they have the laws, series of legislation were made for them. Out of the laws, a similar law of Act 55 of 1958 and another Constitution Act that they are using in 1995. These laws, out of all these laws, propounded and it gave them the opportunity to defend the border and to defend all the illegal groups that are to enter into the country, and at the same time to look for the means of increasing the revenues for the federal government, not to come to the, within the city and to be organizing a kind of roadblocks by harassing our people and at the same time exploiting them.
Honorable Olatoye, in bringing this bill about, in your investigations to make it a matter of consideration for importance, how rampant or rife is this practice amongst the Customs Service operatives to mount roadblocks? And is it also with the foreknowledge of the police?
No, the issue is this. There is nowhere in Nigeria, if you are moving from Lagos to Ibadan, you see them at the toll gate. If you are living from Ogbomosho, your state, to Ilorin, you see them there. If you are living from Ondo to Kogi State, you see them there. From Kogi to Abuja, you see them there. They will be harassing you. And apart from this one, it has been causing a lot of injuries on the part of the masses. Apart from injury, even causing an unwarranted death. A case happened on the way on the 22 August 2015 along the Lagos-Ibadan Expressway, even which is my own part of my own constituency, where the family of four, they were coming from Lagos to Ibadan, and they stopped them on their way at the that they should present their own custom duty, which they have taken initial period that time. They did it. That is why we say, okay, there are a lot of negligence in their duty. Something that is not to have done at the right particular time, they failed to do it. In stopping this family, they stopped. And they gave them the paper. In the process, I want to tell you that a lorry coming and he lost his way. He has to crush this vehicle, and the family of four, they perish. So it's unfortunate. And at the same time, there's no amount of money that custom can give to them. And I want to tell you, the patrol on ground, they left immediately with their gun. Nobody could stop them. Nobody could attack
we could stop them. So, and that is the power we thought. And out of just the law that we have the right and part of our obligations is to make laws, and not only to make laws, to follow it up after we are making laws. And likewise,
thank you, Honorable.
Bill to amend the Constitution and the Electoral Act to include the Vice President and the Deputy Governors in political parties' primary elections. Bill to amend limitation on election expenses, campaign funding by individual candidates to reflect the present economic reality in the country. Motion to upgrade Ibadan Airport to international standard. Motion on the urgent need to investigate the activities of the agencies responsible for land allocation, administration and development control in the Federal Capital Territory. Motion on the need to reconstruct Iwo-Ibadan Road. A bill for an act to amend Electoral Act 2014, in which state elections into the State Houses of Assembly and Office of the Governor are held before elections into the National Assembly and Office of the President. A bill for an act to provide for birth control in Nigeria and other matters connected therewith.
On the issue of birth control, which is in on second stage now, the first reading have gone, we are first, yet at the second reading, it's only the third reading that remains. The provision for this is a bill which may provision and control the population that we are having. We are just having population without having things that are enough to cater for the numbers that we are having. Here in Nigeria, everybody is free to have the number of kids that wants, but that must be controlled. And in case of, if you have three children and the number four come as twins or triplets, that is in contingency, unexpected. The law gives room for that. Except that one, if you have gotten three children, the number four come as one, so you are entitled to have four children.
Bill to amend provisions dealing with inconclusive elections and when a candidate dies before declaration of final results.
On the issue of electoral law, there is a bill that has been voted which gave space to what we call Nakola law. There's no provision for the deputy governor that has never been sworn in into office in the case of death of the elected officer. For example, of what happened at Kogi. After the candidates died before the sworn in, there are a lot of chaos that claims so many lives and property. The opposition party, they are of interest of having another election. Why the ruling party saying they will put the contemporary there. But because our law was unable to provide for this, I stood up on the floor of the house and I made my own submission to reenact that bill, which gives opportunity for every candidate now and every party, no result of any party, that when you are going for primary election, you must go to primary with your running mate.
Contributions on the floor of the House and matters arising, such as the need for the federal government to declare state of emergency in power sector, Nigerian roads, palliative measures for Nigerian masses, while the medium and long-term laudable policies of government are still to materialize.
On the issue of power supply and the area of roads, in this budget proposal that we are holding, we can see vividly that it is only 50 billion that has been allocated to power supply. I know that maybe the executive may I rely on the issue of the PPP. While doing the PPP, it's not the problem, it's the best option. But I want us to learn from the mistake that the last administration made. When they privatized the power sector, they only privatized the distribution section. They failed to privatize generation sector. It's only when you have something to offer, that's why you can distribute or supply. I want us to look at the MTN.
Please allow the speaker.
When they started,
honorable members, please.
The price
please.
Of the team and everything was high.
Members should take their seats, please.
On the issue of economic diversification that we are advocating for, everybody are clamoring for the agricultural aspect of it. The only success that we can have on the level of diversification is when we have a stable power supply. And how can we achieve this one? Is by privatizing the whole sector. And at the same time, when we privatize the whole sector, the generation sector, and at the same time, the distribution sector. And that's why we can achieve our aim. This will help the investors to come to our country to invest. Some investors already on ground, like Benjamin, they have left, and at the same time, some are preparing to go through the sampling that I've done. Over 7,000 people are working with British American Tobacco. They are also willing to go because the cost of production. And the area of power supply that they are having problems, they are using over £4 million every year on it, not only on the British American Tobacco, in the most companies that remains in Nigeria. So I want us to really verify this aspect. The 50 million allocated to that power supply aspect, is it as level of the committee? Is it on the area of support, so on the area of PPP? And at the same time, on the area of road, they have tested it in Lagos through Fashola. We don't need to put our money to build roads again. There are a lot of investors that want to come to Nigeria to invest on roads. When they invest on this road, either within the 5 or 10 years, it's not only them that they will get the money back again. And it will serve as a source of IGR for us as well, where the government and the agent and the investors will be sharing whatever that is coming up. If we give the opportunity of the PPR to the investors, Nigeria doesn't need to borrow much as we are intend to do. So that is my contribution and my quota to you.
Thank you, Honorable Sugar.
There is what God will call the total darkness in number one area in Nigeria. If any visitor is visiting Nigeria, we believe that it will call the federal capital. And when you get the federal capital, the number one place is central area, Abuja, where the House of Rock is being seated, where National Assembly office is being erected, where ministries and parastatals and MDs have been placed to have night for good 8 weeks. And that 8 weeks destroyed a lot of things. I stood up in the House of Representatives and I raised a motion that the federal government should intervene within 48 hours. The job was being done.
Honorable Olatoye Temitope is not only relevant in the National Assembly where laws are made primarily, but he has also touched his constituency and Oyo State in numerous positive dimensions with benevolent gestures which are beyond merely scoring political points. These actions have continued to put smiles on the faces of the people at a price that has stretched even his personal purse extensively, a price he is willing to continue to pay from the proceeds of his farming and other businesses, so far as his people will get more opportunities to continue to smile.
Thank you.
scorecard will reveal, among others, intervention on reconstruction of Abatakun Bridge, Ojo Ibadan.
Another one is the bridge that serves as a border point to the northern part of Nigeria from Oyo State, which is at Ojo here. I visited the place, I moved Amosho on that bridge, that the federal government should do something so that we will not be cut off from the unity that we are preaching within the South and the North. Due to that, the Federal Ministry of House, Works and Housing responded to that effect, sending a letter to my office that the work is already taken over by the World Bank. And expecting that real time of that 3 months that they said they would do it, when they failed, I went to Wajin. I started doing that job myself. 3 weeks after, the World Bank representative, the engineers, they came on board and they begged of me that I should please allow them to continue the work. And now the means of transport from south to north, from north to south, is very solid for my state now. Completion of a modern mosque at Isabatudin Girls Grammar School, General Gas, Ibadan. Construction of ultra-modern complex at Nigerian Television Authority, NTA, Ibadan. Over 16 modern boreholes facilitated across the constituency. Six blocks of three classrooms each with staff room, both in Lagelu and Akinyele respectively. Construction of school hall at Songoibon Community High School, Akinyele Local Government. There is another community in Akinyele called Songoibon, where since the establishment of that school in 1980, they usually take their students, it's a secondary school, to neighboring school for exam, no exam hall. I've been able, by His grace, to construct a standard examination hall for them.
Provision of free eye treatment and glasses through Olatoye Sugar Foundation, OSF, for over 5,000 people.
It is a very good gesture. Very, very good. And I thank God for his life. Honorable Temitope Olatoye Sugar is a prayer warrior, a wonderful man, and a man of God. I really thank him for this gesture. These operations, some are even over 40,000 naira. I did my first eye at Oluyoro Eleta, and I spent over 20,000 naira in 2014. And I have come for another one, of which I think I will do today or this week by the special grace of God. It is a very, very good gesture. May God help him.
Annual Father Christmas Fun Fair for all children in Oyo State. Provision of free surgery for 2,000 people at Oluyoro Catholic Hospital.
to explain all what I've said. Even to start our program today fully. Most of you have been registered. In a week ago and 2 weeks ago, some of you are around and you have been registered. Here is the head of the operation, our doctor from Abuja. He represents the interest of NACA. We call them NACA because this thing that I'm doing is not only low. I have sent for the support of some agency like NACA and as well Akoli Oro. So in a nutshell, you that have an ear, they will do operation for you. You that get, you have fibroid, they will work on you. Cataract, they will work on you as well. And the free gases, you that are not read very well, they will give you the free gases. And I said that drugs that are needed will be given to you. We don't want anybody to fight or to destroy or to obstruct what we have to do here. So we want everything orderly.
Weekly mobile basic health care across Oyo State.
On the area of health, we started what we call mobile health clinic. Here we do normally visit all markets in our localities, like Oyedeji Market, Lalupo Market, Apatare Market, Monia Market.
Construction of Bale Ilegbon Palace, Lagelu, local government. Streetlights for Alafia Estate, Alegungo, Lagelu, local government. Presentation of media equipment to Broadcasting Corporation of Oyo State, BCOS, Ibadan. Visitation to selected industries in Oyo State for improved corporate social responsibility, CSR. Annual stomach infrastructure program for 6 local governments in Oyo State. Presentation of generating sets and cash support to 12 police stations across Oyo State. Christmas cash packages, support to 3 local governments, Lagelu, Akinyele, and Ibadan North. 2015-2016 Ileya Rams and foodstuff distribution across Oyo State. Distribution of 200 artificial limbs to people without legs. Annual Valentine fanfare and empowerment to people living with disabilities across Oyo State. Presentation of 33 kVA transformer to Oke Ibadan Estate, Shawu, Iyano Church, Ibadan. Monthly payment of social welfare allowance, cash support to over 100 people. Ongoing construction of a block of 2 classrooms at the Institute for Peace and Strategic Studies, University of Ibadan. Honorable Olatoye Sugar is not just giving people fish, but he also mainly teaches them how to fish. He will soon be training 10,000 Oyo State youths on information and communication technology. And the people will forever be grateful to him.
Come up from by you. Keep governor sugar. Call the government and you. Bo, pata pata lawa la yin sugar. Oh no, by your man, your test, you are Joe. Tori and Tomomi. Moti diolo gogoro. Momo gogoro, mogogoro. Call law. In one yard, but I say, Bamoa, but program on Mola long cost. So what into Fuwa Kondona? Moba Fest and Boban Sade, but Gala, all on the king say, Congo, call on my back and in a jail. Kọlọ mọ ba mi fi so re so emi na ni adua ti be mo ba se nki wakati marun mo ma sa adua fun kọlọn da kan ọlọn kọlọn je ogun fun wa kọlọn je mi re ogun o gbogbo n to se fun mekunu yi adua ti gbogbo mekunu n se fun ọlọn yo ji o mu ko ni ta se lodo re lagba lowo ọlọn ba emi ne musibau oba bi yi ti mo n gbe ni ilu ibadan.
How would you describe the section?
Oh, it's very, very encouraging. This is the type of people that we need in this state and in Nigeria in general. People who think about others, who think about the feelings that we are in now, this reception. Somebody who can put his money for thousands of people to be treated of different ailments. Honestly, this is the type of people we need in this country. If he's contesting for even presidency, many people will vote for him. I like it. My name is Adebayo Alao.
Sugar's humanitarian efforts are observedly numerous to mention. They are beyond what a politician seeking to score political points would do. Why then would he have been going this far? There is always a next agenda for everyone, the politicians inclusive. What is next for Honorable Olatoye Temitope? With all said and done, the people of Oyo State can rest assured that with Olatoye Temitope Sugar's continuous commitment to helping and serving them, their future is secure to a reasonable degree. Germany Kent said, "If you are not reaching back to help anyone, then you are not building." Honorable Olatoye Sugar has been given the mandate by his people, and he is indeed using this mandate to give them a life worth living. Thank you.